cadence, a melodic or harmonic formula that occurs at the end of a composition, a section, or a phrase, conveying the impression of a momentary or permanent conclusion. Each period of music history has a rather limited number of such formulas, or at least a limited number of models, of which all closing passages are but variations or modifications. The cadences in use during the 18th and 19th centuries have been studied in great detail. Unfortunately, the classification and terminology in this area lack uniformity and frequently also clarity. The following discussion is not intended to present a complete list of terms, but to clarify the essential points. A cadence is called perfect, final, full, if it can be satisfactorily and normally used as the close of a composition. According to the standards of classical harmony, the last chord must be the tonic triad, one, and must have the tonic note in the soprano. For the penultimate chord, there is a choice between the dominant, five, and the subdominant, four, both in root position. The combination 5-1 is called authentic cadence. The combination 4-1 is called plagal cadence. The authentic cadence usually occurs in the fuller form 4-5-1, 2-B-5-1, or still more complete 4-1-B-5-1, 2-B-1-B-4-5-1. The last four are sometimes called mixed cadences. The remaining cadences fall into two classes, imperfect cadences and deceptive or interrupted cadences. The imperfect cadences are the same as the two elementary perfect cadences, except that they have the tonic chord in another arrangement, e.g. with the third or fifth in the soprano, or they have the penultimate chord in inversion. These are called inverted or medial cadences, as opposed to a radical, Latin radix, root, cadence, or occur in transposition to the dominant, or more rarely, the subdominant. These transposed cadences occur almost regularly at the end of the first half of a musical phrase, and are therefore termed half cadence, authentic or plagal. The deceptive cadence is an authentic, or sometimes plagal, cadence, whose tonic chord 1 is, deceptively, replaced by some other chord, most frequently by 6. Some other possibilities are indicated. See also masculine and feminine cadence. The cadences of early music differ sharply from those described above, particularly prior to 1500, when progressions such as 5-1 and 4-1 were very seldom used. The history of these cadences is interesting, since the various formulas are characteristic of their period and may well serve as identifying marks. In Gregorian chant, by far the most frequently used cadential motion is that of the descending second, 2-1, with 3-1 being next in importance. Ascending motion is much rarer and is practically limited to the ascending second, 7-1. It appears more often in later chants, such as hymns and sequences, but almost never as a leading tone, E to F. Prior to 1450, practically all cadences of polyphonic music are based on the progression 2-1 in the lowest part, tenor. This cadence appears with various modifications, among which that with two leading tones, one before the octave and the other before the fifth, is particularly common before and after 1400. After 1400, another modification of the 2-1 cadence appears, in which the contratenor jumps up an octave from the fourth below to the fifth above the tonic. 5-1 movement in the lowest part. This, as well as the plagal cadence, was introduced about 1450 as a result of the addition of a true bass to musical texture, Ockeghem, Obrecht, Flemish school. The earlier type, 2-1, survived only in the so-called Phrygian cadence. It should be noted that until 1500, the third is almost always omitted in the final chord of the authentic as well as the plagal cadence. See triad, picardy, third. In the 16th century, the suspension formula was universally accepted, while in the 17th century, the anticipation formula is very common. Composers of the 17th century frequently used both formulas simultaneously in two parts, violins, in a strikingly dissonant combination known as Corelli clash. The cadences of the classical and romantic periods are of little interest, since they usually conform to the standard types already outlined. Towards the end of the 19th century, however, the amplification of the harmonic vocabulary brought with it numerous novelties in the writing of cadences, such as the use of modal cadences, the use of a dissonant final chord, polytonal formations, and later, the return to a contrapuntal type of cadence